From next year, students at QUT will be at the forefront of creating the medical marvels of the future. They'll be developing everything from bones to breasts to keep our bodies running longer. Christina Castalis has more.
It looks like a prickly sponge, but this 3D printer device could help women grow back new breasts after a mastectomy.
My dream is that I'll be putting my hand up as the first person to have this type of implant.
Eliza Whiteside is a breast cancer survivor. She says the medical procedure, which could be available in just 2 years, would be life-changing.
The advantages of this particular type of implant was symmetry, the same volume.
The process to make the implant is called biofabrication. Layer by layer, 3D printers build the frame, but instead of ink, the printer uses bio-ink, which is infused with the patient's stem cells. Inside the body, over time, the implant gradually dissolves, allowing new tissue to grow in its place.
You can see that there's this ability for the blood vessels to grow all the way through the scaffold, and this enables the nutrients to go into the scaffold to feed the cells, to enable them to proliferate, differentiate.
But the bio ink used to build the implants doesn't come cheaply.
1 gram of this material costs actually $5,000.
Scientists today are using 3D technology to repair bone, skin and cartilage, but predict it'll be some time before they're able to grow organs such as the heart or liver.
We predict it will be possible in 50 years to regrow organs.
From next year, QUT will offer the world's first master's degree in biofabrication.
And it will really equip them to pioneer the development of this new field.
But just 20 students from Australia will be selected. Christina Castalis, 10 Eyewitness News.